Hello, Wednesday School. Pastor Grant here for another episode from On the Road. Today we're coming to you from Iowa. This is the church that Pastor Amanda and I were married in. And today we're going to be spending a little bit more time talking about the Lord's Prayer and all about how Jesus loves us. And so I'm excited for you guys. We're going to sing some songs, some you know, some that are new, and we're going to have some fun today. So our first song for today is a new one. This is called Peace Like a River. All right, so repeat after me. I've got peace like a river. Your turn. I've got peace like a river. Good. I've got peace like a river. Your turn.
Yeah. Peace.
Very good. I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. So try that. I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. Very good. And when we say soul, we hit the bottom of our foot, and that's a little bit of a joke because the word that we're really meaning is a word that comes all the way back from Hebrew nefesh, which means the innermost part of my life, the fullness of who I am. So I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in the innermost part of me. But it's hard to point to the innermost me. So instead, we make a little joke, and the bottom of your foot is also called soul, spelled differently. That's what we're doing there. So we've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. All right? I've got peace like a river in my soul. So those are the words. And then the chorus goes like this. It goes, because Jesus. Try that. Jesus. Very good. Jesus. You go. Jesus. Very good. Jesus. Your turn. Jesus. Jesus is the power in my soul. In my soul. So you try that. Jesus is the power in my soul, in my soul. Very good. All right, so now we're going to try the whole thing. Here we go. You ready? I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got peace like a river in my soul. Because Jesus, Jesus is the power in my soul, in my soul. Let's try it one more time. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river. I've got peace like a river, and it's flowing in my soul. I've got peace like a river in my soul. Because Jesus is the power in my soul, in my soul. Very good. There's going to be a couple more verses. We'll learn those next week. The next song you know very well. This is If I Were a Butterfly. If I were a butterfly, I thank you, Lord, for giving me wings. And if I were a robin in a tree, I thank you, Lord, that I could sing. And if I were a fish in the sea, well, I wiggle my tail and I giggle with glee. But I just thank you, Father, for making me me. Because you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me your child. Well, I just thank you, Father, for making me me. If I were an elephant, I'd thank you, Lord, by raising my trunk. And if I were a kangaroo, you know I'd hop right up to you. And
If I were an octopus, well, I'd thank you, Lord, for my good looks. But just thank you, Father, for making me me. Because you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me your child. But I just thank you, Father, for making me me. If I were a wiggly worm, I thank you, Lord, that I could squirm. And if I were a fuzzy wuzzy bear, I thank you, Lord, for my fuzzy wuzzy hair. And if I were a crocodile, well, I thank you, Lord, for my great smile. But I just thank you, Father, for making me me. Because you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me your child. Well, I just thank you, Father, for making me me. Because you gave me a heart and you gave me a smile. You gave me Jesus and you made me your child. Well, I just thank you, Father, for making me me.
Our next song is a new one for you. This is 1 John 4, 7, and 8, and it comes to us from the Bible. And so the words are pretty simple, and I'll teach them to you now. The words are, beloved, beloved. And what beloved means is it's just a way of speaking to people you love. And so this was when John was writing to other Christians, he talked to them as beloved because they were loved by him and they're loved by God. Just as you all are loved by me and loved by God. So beloved, beloved, let us love one another. Let us love one another. So let's love one another. For love is from God. For love is from God. And everyone who loves is born of God. And everyone who loves is born of God. And knows God. And knows God. He who does not love, he who does not love does not know God, does not know God, for God is love, for God is love. Beloved, beloved, let us love one another, let us love one another. 1 John 4, 7 and 8, 1 John 4, 7 and 8. And so I'll sing it for you now, and then I'll invite you to join in with me. So go ahead and listen to it. And then we'll sing it together in a little bit. So here it goes. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Beloved, love one another, 1 John 4, 7, and 8. All right, now try singing with me. We'll sing it through twice. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Let us love one another, 1 John 4, 7 and 8. Beloved, let us love one another. For love is from God, and everyone who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. Beloved, let us love one another, 1 John 4, 7, and 8. So for our prayer today, I'd like you to take on an attitude of prayer. And this time, we're going to be doing it kneeling. And I want you to take your hands and put one hand in the other one and just hold them out so that you're ready to receive from God all that God has to offer. And what we're going to do, we're going to take some time and just be silent and listen for God and listen for what all that God has to give. Think about all that what God has to give to us,
all of what God has given us. And then I'm going to want to tell you to take your hands and hold them up to your mouth, and I want you to whisper all the things that you're worried about, all the things that you're hopeful about, all the things that you want to say to God. And then what we're going to do is I'm going to count to three, and you're going to lift it up and let it go and release it to God and say amen. Okay? Okay. So let's begin. Now put your hands up. Three, two, one. Amen.
So today we get the second half of a song we started learning last week. This is the Lord's Prayer, and you guys are studying the Lord's Prayer right now. And so I wanted you to hear a song that Cambodian folks sing, where they take one of their favorite folk tunes and they put the words of the Lord's Prayer to it. And so we learned the first part last time, and this is how that went.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, here on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses. Lord, forgive as we forgive those who trespass against us. Forgive us, Lord, forgive us, Lord.
So that's the first half. And then the second half goes like this. Repeat after me. And lead us not, and lead us not into temptation, into temptation. Lead us not, lead us not. But deliver us from evil, from evil. Lord, we pray your mercy. Lord, we pray your mercy. For thine is the kingdom. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever, amen, 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 amen. And so it's the same tune, and we just repeat it again for that second part. I'm going to sing the whole thing through twice. Join in with me as you feel comfortable. So here we go.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, here on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive our trespasses. Lord, forgive as we forgive those who trespass against us. Forgive us, Lord.
Us
Amen.